Robin Hoffman. I'm a Charlottesville public artist, and some people might ask, what's a public artist? Well, a public artist is somebody who does art, public art in the public. And sometimes, you know, on the downtown mall, for instance, it's a beautiful day, and we get to just like set up here and just hope, you know, some customers will come by. And if they come by, you know, then I can draw them. And hopefully I can raise money and awareness for different causes as well. You see, an artist who does initiatives and deducts sort of percentages off of their income toward donating to different causes actually can buy their materials tax-free. So that's something that happened in the law, which is our taxable income this year. So I'm going to proceed by starting to, hopefully somebody will come over and do want their portrait done. And so I'm hoping that somebody will come over and we'll see what happens. Oh, hello there. How are you?
Good.
What's your name?
Jamie Sacco.
Oh my goodness, Jamie, can you stand over here so I can do your caricature? Would you like your caricature today?
Sure.
Oh my goodness, this is so awesome. So I guess you're over here for a reason.
I am.
What?
I work there.
Oh my goodness. Awesome. So what is this place that we're standing in front of?
Am
I allowed to stand in front of this place for now?
You are.
Oh, you're so nice. Thank you very much.
This is Snooky's Pawn Shop.
Uh-huh. And today I want to just say that, you know, you're so awesome and gracious. We just came over here and you're going to be donating for the free clinic today. And so, and that just shows the community why we have to support you, because you're supporting the employees here who work behind the scenes on the counters and everything else who need a provider. And with any kind of donation, they can sustain themselves for free or next to free or sliding scale free providers. These are volunteers from UVA and Martha Jefferson, doctors, pharmacists, dentists, and nurses. And anyway, and for you to know that and to be a supporter of that is just awesome. It helps our community, and I want to thank you so much. So tell us about your, tell us, first of all, what is this store you have over here?
The Snooky's Pawn Shop. I opened this back in 1993.
Oh.
And it's going to be 20 years in January. Thank you. We deal in musical instruments, jewelry, electronics. We buy, sell, and loan money on those items.
So I walked in there the other day and I saw ukuleles.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh, that's such a hot item these days.
That has been a good item for us.
Uh-huh, because first of all, ukuleles are portable. They're very attractive for musicians who want to just play wherever.
Yep.
Kind of like me with my portable easel, huh?
I guess. It's only got four strings, too.
Yes.
It's got to be a little bit easier.
So now, how did this all happen? How did you make this decision, and how come you are so successful and all this kind of stuff? What do you think is the reason?
Successful? Probably because we care about our customers, and we treat everybody fairly, and we're honest people.
Okay, so I'm doing nuances over here. What's your favorite thing to do ever?
My favorite thing to do ever is to ride motorcycles.
Oh, me too. I love motorcycles. Yay. So now, are you a hobbyist or are you actually like have classic motorcycle? What do you do?
Right now I'm not riding. I've got problems with my hands.
Oh, I'm sorry.
I just had a couple operations on my hands. I'm not riding at the moment.
Oh, alright. And so do you have a Harley? What do you like?
I drive Harleys.
Uh-huh. A real motorcycle person.
Yep.
Yeah, they don't say hello. They don't make any, they don't even recognize me when I'm on the road. I got a Honda. Nothing. Okay, we didn't say any brand names. But anyway, and now, do you actually reside in Charlottesville?
I do. I live in the county and I actually own this building.
Uh-huh.
And we're we're in the process now of putting an apartment upstairs above the store, so that's under construction at the moment.
So, now, what would you say was your most fun that you've ever been in Charlottesville? What do you love to do here?
What do I love to do?
Yeah, like most fun that you always have.
I usually enjoy the time spent at the pavilion, shows, entertainment.
Uh-huh.
And I don't know, lately I've been going to the wineries.
Uh-huh. So, and were you raised here or?
No. Uh-huh. I'm from Jersey.
Oh, what part of Jersey?
Hackensack.
No way.
Yep.
I had a house there in Teaneck for 16 years.
Oh yeah? I was born in Teaneck.
So you went to high school there or whatever?
I did, yeah.
Oh Hackensack, my goodness.
Yep.
Wow, that's so awesome. So you probably know Janine. Janine Beer?
No.
No, you don't know Janine? Okay,
no.
So Janine is my best friend, and she went to Teaneck High and all that. Okay, so, and one of the things that Charlottesville has that probably... Can you spell your first name?
J-A-M-I-E.
One of the things that Charlottesville has that probably I recognize that New Jersey doesn't have are people who just say, okay, and they just do it. They don't make like a whole big deal, and you are one of those generous people today, and I'm so proud of you to be, you know, part of what is really the legacy of the downtown mall, because people who have sustained, it's usually because they're usually community-minded, I think. You know, we just sort of marketing here. We were just like walking up and down, and the people that said yes are the ones who are thriving.
Yeah.
So it seems like I think that might be the key. So what's your, I'm doing this caricature, so I kind of want to know a little more about your nuances. We do it in color, and so what's your favorite color? What do you think?
Light blue.
All right. Wow, that's so awesome. So what I do is I make the, see, I'm an artist here in Charlottesville, and for about 6 years, and I work for the public in that I raise money, but also the public gives back to me because I work for the public, sort of like you, but, and so I do different things, like I work for the city, and I work for different initiatives, like Alzheimer's events and things like that. So every year I've always... And, you know, working for the free clinic has been my invitation to a lot of, you know, openings and things like that. And so I get to meet people from Charlottesville, and I'm just so excited to live here. But also because I noticed that when people are from different places, such as New Jersey, you know, they kind of like... If they are successful, they sort of fit in with a community-centered kind of feeling. Do you have any people that go to school here? Or?
I do. My daughter actually is going to be a first-year student at UVA this year.
Oh,
my youngest daughter. So.
Congratulations.
Be an empty nester. Finally.
Yeah, I have a cousin going there for engineering.
Oh,
so
yeah.
I'm actually helping him with his laundry a lot of times. Because he was a first year. And so yeah, it's a nice community to be able to, you know, talk about you know, local events and also things that are happening on the currently on in the pavilion during the summertime. We're here in the summertime, so, and it's been kind of mild today, so I want to talk about a lot, of course, is because we are in front of your store. I would like to talk a little bit more about the content. What do you think is the most appealing thing, the best sellers, things like that in your store?
Probably musical instruments and jewelry. That's our biggest percentage of items sold.
And why do you think the jewelry, and, is that because of your pricing or?
Yeah, we're probably half a retail.
Uh-huh.
On most of our jewelry, and we've got a nice collection.
And what else do you have in your store so people will know like when they want to go shopping, they can come here first for a lot of things.
We have everything from car stereos, video games, small electronics, home stereo, iPods, iPads, book readers now are a big item, computers, musical instruments, coins, just about anything, collectibles, whatever.
Did you ever have like the most incredible treasure in the world? Like, you know, I sometimes watch, what's that called, that auction thing with the storage units?
Oh yeah.
Oh my goodness, and then these guys like open up these storage units,
yeah.
And then all of a sudden there's like this treasure. Did anybody ever come to you and say, this is a treasure, how much?
Yeah, we've had items like that. My biggest treasure is still in there. It's the totem pole that was actually hand-carved by a Native American Indian. One of my favorite things that I've gotten in here. And I'll keep that.
And how did that happen?
I was actually made for a woman who was downsizing her house and didn't have room for it anymore. And I've done business with her in the past. She came to me to sell it.
And as far as less severe or less important or less passionate, but something that somebody, for instance, maybe unique that somebody brought in that you could talk about a little bit.
Stands out. I mean, I see a lot of the same stuff day in and day out. You know, basic stuff that, you know, people can borrow money on and they'll come back and they'll pick it up. And, like I said, most of it is, you know, it's the same stuff over and over again.
But for the consumer like myself, it's kind of an interesting sort of, what do you call that? You know, not having to go to a garage sale, kind of knowing that you've looked over the quality and that you've sort of seen, you know, really what its value is before we get here. I think that's what your job is, right?
Yep, pretty much.
Can you explain that a little bit? How do you research stuff?
Well, when we started 20 years ago, we used nothing but catalogs. So technology's really changed. Everything's pretty much done on the internet now. Whether we're looking at auction sites or just prices of new items, just do an evaluation. I have some experts that I can call on certain items. I don't charge people to do the research, whether they sell it or not, and I'll still do it for them if they need help trying to sell an item. I would say 80% of it's done on the internet.
So what's the process? Do I come in and with my like ruby from my grandmother, you know, ring, and then you kind of like look at it or whatever, and then do you tell me to come back, or what do you do?
Oh, no. It's instant. Everything we do is instant.
Okay.
You know, usually most transactions can be done in 15 minutes.
Okay.
Unless it requires a lot of research, then I may ask you to leave the item or leave the information and I'll look it up for you and get back to you. There's two ways. I mean, if it's something you just need to borrow money on, I'll lend you money on it based on the value. Or if you want to sell it outright, usually you'll get a little bit more money that way. And we'll look up the used market value, and then depending on how sellable the item is where I determine and see if we can agree on a price.
Again, I'm sorry to trouble you, but I am doing this caricature of you. So it's gotta be about you a little bit more. And so I need a little bit more about your nuances, if you don't mind. So you have a daughter who's at UVA.
I have three daughters.
So one is a university student.
One is a student.
What is she? Does she have long hair or short hair?
Long.
Long hair. And then you have another one?
I have a 23-year-old daughter.
Ah. What's her hair like?
Long.
Long.
Blonde.
Blonde. Good. And then what?
And then I have a 27-year-old daughter.
Uh-huh. Long, blonde?
No. Long, brown.
Brown. Good. All right. And who else?
That's
dogs,
it.
Cats?
Two dogs.
Oh, what kind of dogs?
I've got a 5-pound, 13-year-old black poodle.
Oh! I've actually.
And then a 5-year-old golden doodle.
Oh! So one is black and one is gold. One is golden. Golden.
Yeah, he's golden.
Golden. I actually am doing portraits now of families with their dogs.
Oh yeah.
Like a whole scene thing.
Uh huh.
And so I'm really appreciating like the way the dogs lay down now, and the way they pose. And their characters and all that, and in the family, and how important it is. So, yeah. So, now, do you play golf or something?
No.
No?
No.
Motorcycles?
No, motorcycles.
Motorcycles. So, basically, do your daughters, you think, enjoy Charlottesville as well?
My middle one's here. My older one lives down in Sarasota, Florida.
Oh. Yeah, thanks, sir. And, so the one who's here is the one that's going to UVA?
Two of them here.
Two of them here?
Two of them here. The youngest one is 18, is going to UVA.
Aha. Do you think they use Charlottesville much? I mean, the downtown mall and all that?
honestly, neither one of them.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
They have other interests.
Yeah? That's interesting. Okay. So, we have been very fortunate today because we didn't even know about your store until we came here today. I did, but I didn't really know. And so the thing that is interesting to me for, as a buyer, as a consumer, as a person who is always looking and looking and looking, is that the uniqueness of a store that collects things from people's passions or loves or interests to begin with is going to be interesting for me as an artist, because it means that, you know, it's not cookie-cutted kind of manufactured necessarily kind of items. So, and you can't get that unless you go to somebody's house and you have to drive all the way up the mountains or whatever. So for you to do all the work for us in a way, this is a wonderful opportunity to be here at Snooky. And so I just want to thank you so much, and thank you for being so generous today. And being able
welcome.
To donate. And let me just give you a sort of a little token of that appreciation as well. It's a portrait of you in front of Snooky's. And actually, I wanted to put Snooky's on the background, so let me just do that.
That's great.
And what we're gonna do is hopefully we're gonna highlight some of those wonderful items you have there. And hopefully during Christmas and times when people want to buy those unique items, we're going to air you and let people see what they can buy, the opportunities that Snooky has. So
wonderful.
Here you are, signed, sealed, delivered.
Thank you.
And one of the things I do on the back of them is I put my drawing and my email, so you know it's an authentication. When I croak, you can like...
That brings up the value.
Yeah. You know about value.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. So this is a Robin Hoffman original, so
very
thank
good.
You so much.
Thank you.
Oh.
Nice meeting you.
You too.
Her boots were brown, she leave town to play the role of lover expatriate. A nod to the waiter, always her flirty behavior. You know she always gets one on the house. Then she pulls out a letter from a bag that's under her sweater. And before she reads, she straightens her blouse. There's a passion in being alone. A grace in a loveless time. There's no new cross. There is no new sign. Only the sun and the change. One tear falls like a feather, then it disappears on the barroom floor. The gratuity included, you know the